the most meaningful verse I ever wrote. I went for a meeting with L.A. Reid one time right before Christmas, and he had the whole label in the room, and he said, Yelawolf's about to perform a cappella for y'all. And I was like, no, I'm not. I got a show tomorrow night. Y'all want to come see it? I'm opening up for Raekwon, but I ain't performing in your office, bro. And he was like, well, get the fuck out of here, man. And I was like, all right, peace. They couldn't believe I did that. It was right before Christmas. He was going to give me a deal right there, you know, sign a paperwork right there. But I was so over performing in people's offices. But I went home that Christmas and I was feeling really bad about my decision because I was broke. I didn't have shit, like fucking borrowing money to buy presents for my kids and shit. And I went to Waffle House and I wrote this long verse on a napkin. I memorized it for months and months, hoping to get another chance to go back to the office and redeem myself and possibly get a deal. So L.A. Reid called after Trump Music came out and asked for another meeting. So I went to his office respectfully and I walked in and it was just him. Just him, his boy, and my friend. He was like, I used to be you, man. That's why I became a CEO, because I didn't wanna do what these CEOs were doing. I was an artist. I wanted to bring what an artist brings to a presidential level. And I was like, yeah, well, I wrote something for you. He goes, oh yeah. Well, I wasn't gonna ask you to rap this time. He kind of laughed. Then I stood up and I turned my back and I walked to the window overlooking New York City. And I just fucking delivered a very heartfelt, very fucking dramatic, truthful, honest verse. But I turned around and like, there was tears in this dude's eyes, man. You know, and that was probably the most important, impactful verse that no one will ever hear. He offered a deal after that. The verse that I kicked for L.A. Reid, I wrote for L.A. Reid. You know, it wasn't for anyone else. It's just for him to listen to. Yeah, it's just like a fucking, like a greeting card, like a singing telegram. And the cab leaving there, KP says, what you think? I was like, have you played my stuff for Eminem yet? And he goes, dude, please. True story. 6 months later, Shady Records.